Whatever I see, I shall devour.
Problems I addressed in Zelda 1 again while I'm present here, so there's not much need to go into such detail again. It has the same style of gameplay and the same cheesy cutscenes.
Do you know what that means when you lose your last ruby? Now you work for me! Take him away!
You're doing great, Link! You're our hero!
Man, those fairies really like Link. The only real difference with this game is that you play as Link, and this time you're going to rescue Zelda, so the roles have been reversed. If you watch the demo, Link tells you how to play the game.
Move the controller down, and I crouch. When I'm crouching, Q can make me do the duck walk. Cool, huh?
One difference is that you have to collect snowballs and fireballs. There's some enemies that can only be killed by either of these weapons, so it only adds more to your inventory that you have to keep up with. So even more so than the other games, you spend half the time collecting these items and collecting rupees so that you can buy bombs, rope, and lantern oil. And to top it off, there's more weapons that drain your rupees. Could this be any more tedious? And I hate collecting rupees. Come on, you can't even get two at the same time? And the jumping is still a big problem. Come on, why can't I get up there? Oh, it's your mother. Oh, you son of a bitch. Get up there. Worst example is right here. I'm trying to go in the door. Seems simple, right? But I can't approach the door from any conceivable angle. If I'm below the door, I can't reach it, at least not without a rope. Too bad I had to use them all in order to get this far. I can't approach it from the other side because the pillar is blocking me. This is the part I really don't understand. You can pass through the bottom of the pillar and you can pass through the two pillars before it, which look exactly the same. Why is it that I can't go through this one fucking part? It seems the only way I can make it is to drop down from the top, but I can't get back up there. I'm jumping everywhere. I obviously can't go back up, which is ironically the way I came, all because I missed the jump, which is hard to begin with because you're so close to the ceiling. I'm also prohibited from going to the left. Whether I'm on the top or the bottom floor, there's a fucking piece of shit in the way. So once you fall down there, you're stuck. This is a joke. They designed this part of the stage to be a trap. The only way to get out of this is to stand here and let the falling spikes kill you. If it wasn't for them, you'd have to reset the game and lose all your data. The darkness is still a huge issue. Look, my lantern oil ran out, so I can't find my way back. So I'm really up shit creek without a paddle. And that means I'm paddling through the shit with my hands. Talking to people is still a strange ordeal. Why do you have to shove a sword up their ass? Right up their ass.
Wow!
You also use a sword to buy stuff. If the shop owner gets in your way, you end up talking to him. Go away, I'm trying to buy bonds.
Lamp oil, rope.
And here, once again, I'm trying to fight, but I keep talking to this asshole. Go away.
Through the eye of Glutko.
The enemies, once again, are a pain in the ass. Half of them are impossible to hit.
Look at this, I'm trying to go down, but the fucking warthogs are in my way.
This would be so simple if you could just duck down.
Oh my goodness, this is awful!
Another nuisance is I can't hit the dodongos because the bombs just fly over them. If I could duck and throw the bomb, maybe I could hit them, but you can't do that because it activates the status screen. Yeah, you have to be standing to use your items. And I hate these damn snakes. Your timing has to be perfect. I hate these fucking bastards! But these gargoyle things are the worst. They take several hits to kill, and they never stop coming. If you stay there and try to fight them off, you'll be there forever. I'm not kidding. It makes the most sense to try and outrun them. All right, Ganon, here I come.
And I will make you face the greatest in Kuradai, or else you will die.
All I need is just one shot with a book. Yeah, it's a book this time. Just one hit.
No,
that doesn't count.
The
I still get the dramatic death scene, but I'm back outside the castle. Fuck. So I gotta go all the way through the castle again, and when I get there, thankfully Ganon's still dead. Then you gotta wake Zelda. Come on, I'm here to rescue your royal ass. Get the hell up. Wake the fuck up. Oh, I get it.
I just saved you from Ganon. I won.
Nothing short of poetry. Let's move on to the final piece of what's known as the Unholy Triforce. Zelda's Adventure was released the following year, in 1994. Unlike the other two, this one doesn't have the cartoon cutscenes. Instead, it's digitized actors. Sometimes they don't even move, they just cross-fade.
So I found this champion of strength and courage!
As the title would suggest, it's the only other game where you play as Zelda, going to save Link's ass once again. You have to find dungeons where in each one you collect a piece of a stone, much like pieces of the Triforce in the original Zelda game. So this one follows the classic format a little more, not to mention it's an overhead view. That means you don't have to do stupid shit like push up to jump and crouch to bring up the inventory screen. You can also touch the rupees and hearts without having to attack them. Of course, you do have to wait for them to touch the ground, which is confusing since it's overhead. It's better than the other two CDI games, but not by a whole lot. The most constant annoying thing is waiting for the screen to load. Watch how long it takes. And you're probably thinking, oh, it can't do that every time. Oh yeah, it does. Imagine how long it takes you to get anywhere. Look at the original Zelda, watch how quick it is. See, and that was on an old 8-bit console. Damn CD load time, look at this. That's when you grab your beard. The next thing that's really annoying is that somebody keeps talking to you.
Zelda, Zelda, do not roam, Uncle Tess.
Shut the fuck up.
Look at me, there's something to aid you.
What is Zelda hearing voices in her head? Crazy bitch. Unlike other Zelda games where the dialogue is all text, this one uses real bad voice acting.
Hey, those who go deep into the earth learn to overcome the sins of grief.
Hey, who goes there? Aren't you letting me and my boss look? You can't come in here.
Even the sound effects aren't appropriate. Why do the buyers have humanoid grunts? And what the hell is that thing? What is
there
that?
Are no grunts out there. It's so slow and stupid.
You don't get very much music here. Just immerse yourself in the good old outdoors. I also find the ground very strange looking. Almost like a satellite view. These would be trees, so maybe Zelda's a giant. Oh look, we got a ladder. Remember that from the original Zelda? Remember how to use it? You just walk right across. Let's see how easy it is here. You come to a gap, you gotta go to your menu, select the ladder, and then use it. You always have to select shit. Take this for example. In any good Zelda game, how do you buy stuff? Like this. That's easy, right? Here, you gotta stop, bring up the menu, select the rupee, and there. What a bunch of fuck.
That was the last pitches, young princess.
And I gotta say, the menu screen sucks. First of all, you can only hold one item. That includes the sword or a wand, whatever. In the other games, you always have the sword and can select an additional item. Of course, the CDI doesn't utilize as many buttons, so whenever you need to use something, you bring up the menu screen. screen. And the other thing that really pisses me off is that you have to scroll through the items, not by pressing left or right on the D-pad, no, by moving the cursor to the left or right arrow and painstakingly clicking until you see the item you want. That is bullshit. Why couldn't they fit them all on the screen like the other games? And how about the map screen? In any other Zelda game, you can bring up the map with the ease of a single button. That's simple, right? Well, here, the map screen is inside the item screen. Yeah, so whenever you want to see the map, you have to bring up the item screen, select the map, look at the map, go back to the item screen, and finally back to the game. How about getting treasure? You think you just open it and there'd be nothing more to look than that? But no, the fucking treasure chest starts talking to you. Then it spits out the treasure, and the first time I didn't even know what happened. Whatever happened to this? How about this shit? Somebody gives me an empty bottle and tells me to go fill it up at the source of the river. Well, I can't just go to any riverbank, I don't know. But anyway, I go to the source, which is this fucking stove thing. I select the bottle, and then it doesn't just fill up. It mysteriously disappears from Zelda's hands and then reappears behind her to the left. What? You're never even sure what the items are gonna do. I got a flute, and I was told to use it against the snake. So I use the flute, and what happens? It kills the snake, but not before freezing me, making me momentarily helpless while the snake nearly kills me. Thanks. But one major problem I have is that the save function doesn't seem to work. If I turn off the game, it erases all the data. That sucks. The overall design is horrendous. You can never tell where to go. See that dark area right there? That's a cave. You're supposed to go in there. But with all the random rock patterns, you think it was just part of the wall. And when I got to this part, I thought it was a hole in the floor, until I realized that it's just part of the ceiling. Rarely does that even happen, and it occurs right after the part where you need a ladder. So naturally, I thought it was a hole. Here, I'm just trying to go to the right, but something apparently is blocking my path. What the fuck's going on? Oh shit, I'm gonna die. Get over there. I'm stuck. Even the dungeon maps aren't consistent. See the white square? That's where I am. But if I go up, it jumps me all the way up here. And it happens more than once. You just jump all over the map. In other Zelda games, there's secret passageways that transport you all around the dungeon. That makes sense. But here, when you're just walking to the next screen and suddenly appear someplace different on the map, it's like, what the hell happened to this game? I don't believe this. I seriously don't believe this. That's it. That's all I can take. How could they fuck up Zelda this bad? It's not a Zelda game. I wouldn't call it that. Oh, but it is. It has Zelda and it has Link. Yeah, you know what? That's a pointless argument right there. That's like if your dad says, I fucked your mom. It's like, I can't argue with that. You're playing these games, it's as worthwhile as melting a dog turd in a frying pan. Yeah, put some buffalo puke and some cat piss all over it, and you have a shit sandwich that is Zelda CI. This game fucking sucks! Fucking sucks! Fucking sucks! Oh yeah, the Mario game, that one sucks too! CI sucks! Thank you.